This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, here's another rate time distance problem. A jogger started running at an average speed of 6 miles per hour. Half an hour later, another runner started running after him, starting from the same place at an average speed of 7 miles per hour. How long will it take for the runner to catch up to the jogger? Okay, so we start off with a jogger, right? So let's just get a picture of this. The jogger is going along and eventually ends up someplace. And there's a runner that leaves a little bit later, but the runner catches up to the jogger. So you can see by the picture that they actually both go exactly the same distance, right? So let's do a little chart so we could fill something in for their rate and their time. So we've got a jogger and a runner. Each one has a rate and a time. And we want to fill those in, and then we want to multiply them together to figure out what we're going to put in the distance. And then after we know that, we'll fill it on up here at our picture. So do we know the jogger's rate? Well, it says a jogger started running at an average speed of 6 miles per hour. So yes, jogger's going 6 miles per hour. Do we know the runner's rate? Well, we read along and we see that the runner went 7 miles per hour. Okay, so we know that. Now the time's the tricky part. We don't know the time of either of them, but we do know one thing. We know that the runner left in half an hour later. So think about this. Who is running longer, the jogger or the runner? Remember, the jogger starts off first, and then the runner leaves later. So who is running longer? Okay, and I'm going to write that down. The jogger. The jogger runs a half an hour longer, right? Since he left first, he's actually running longer. So his time had better be more than the jogger's time. So that's my hint here. I'm sorry, than the runner's time. So if the runner went X, the jogger went a half an hour longer, X plus 1/2. A lot of people do this exactly the opposite. They'll add 1/2 to the runner, but that doesn't make sense because the runner left after the jogger had already been going. Now, you don't have to do it this way. You could let the jogger be a variable and then subtract 1/2 for the runner. That would work as well. I find it's easier for most people to use plus. So whoever is going longer, you just add to their time. The second thing to be careful of is you might want to put X plus 30, but you can't do that, and here's why. The speed is in miles per hour, so the time has to also be in hours, okay? So if the speed is in miles per hour, then that means the distance is in miles and the time is in hours, okay? So it all has to agree. So now how do we get the distance? For the jogger, we do the jogger's rate times their distance. So that's 6 times x plus 1/2. And that can be simplified if you do the distributive property. 6 times x is 6x plus 6 times 1/2. Well, what's 6 times 1/2? That would be 3. So the jogger's distance is 6x plus 3. Now, what about the runner's distance? It's a little bit easier. It's just 7 times x, so 7x. And this is what we want to put up here on the little picture for their distance. So the jogger's distance is 6x plus 3, so let's write 6x plus 3. That's the length that represents. And the runner's distance is 7x. So we can put that right here. All right, now we want to look at the picture. The picture is always what helps us write the equation. So from the picture, look at their distances. Can you see how to relate them in any way? And they're both the same distance. So that means the jogger's distance is the same as the runner's distance. So we're just going to equal those. I'm going to put the runner's first. So I'm going to put 7x. Oops. 7x. I'm having a little trouble. All right, so we have 7x. That's the runner's distance up here. That line segment is the same thing as the 6x plus 3. And so now we have this equation to solve. Subtract 6x from both sides. And that tells us x is 3. Now remember, the question is not, what is x? Okay? Although that might, whatever x is, might be the answer, but we have to go back and answer the question. But before doing that, we want to sort of do a little check in the chart. Remember how we did that before? So we're going to make a chart again now that we know what x is. So we've got the jogger, the runner, each has a rate and a time. We're going to multiply those together to get the distance. Rate times time equals distance. And we already knew their rates, 6 and 7. And now, what does x stand for? X stands for the time of the runner. So it goes right here, the time of the runner is 3. So we know how to get the distance for the runner, 7 times 3, 21 miles. Right, and what do we know about the jogger? He left a half an hour earlier, so he had an extra half hour of running, so it's 3.5 or 3.5. It's up to you how you want to write that. You could write 3.5, you could write 3.5. But you have to multiply 6 times 3.5. Right, so if you forget how to multiply 6 times 3.5, I'm going to give you a little, an easy way to do it is just like we had originally, 6 times x plus 1/2, just go ahead and put the 3 in for x. So you have 6 times 3 is 18 plus 6 times 1/2. So that's one way of doing 6 times 3.5. The other way is to do 6 times and change 3.5 to 7/2, and go ahead and cancel. And you're still going to get 21 that way. Lastly, you could do 6 times 3.5, get out a piece of paper, and do it like this. Move the decimal in. You're still going to get 21. All right, so that's just a little review of how to multiply 6 times 3.5 or 6 times 3.5. But here's the question. Does this make sense? Right? So the jogger went 6 miles an hour for 3.5 hours, 21 miles. So, gosh, did they catch up to each other? Well, let's get that picture again. Here's the jogger. Here's the runner. Okay, the jogger went 21 miles and the runner went 21 miles. So, yes, it all seems to check out. So that's our check. We make the little table, we look at it on the picture, and now we answer the question. So let's go back up to the question. How long will it take for the runner to catch up to the jogger? So it's asking you for the runner's time, right? However long it takes the runner to catch up is the runner's time. So in this case, the variable that we solve for, the 3, also just happened to be the answer. But basically, it's asking this, right? Well, how long did it take the runner? So it took the runner 3 hours. All right. Again, best way to learn how to do these is first, watch, copy, put the video on pause and back up if you need to until you get all the way through the end, and then try it all on your own. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.